in the last episode of Day and the Dream. I was struggling with the attacks from the enemy for a while that were so bad that I was reverting back to some old tendencies. After getting somewhat back on track after being in a decline for a while, God sends me multiple TikToks to make me reevaluate myself. After watching a specific one, real change began. I got chills. So something just slid into me, right? And I think this is God prompting me, because this is not the first time I have to stop. I had to stop maybe like yesterday and the day before that, like, and it just came back to me, but more prominent in my head. I'm a billionaire now. But that's not it. It wasn't about that. It was, now that you're a billionaire, where do you want to buy a house? How are you going to start carrying out your purpose? What are you going to do? How are you going to do this? Now that you've gotten that money that you want so bad, how are you going to proceed forward? And that is what I don't know.
With that thought in my head, it felt like a prompt to start thinking about my life and the long run of things. I'm gonna be honest, y'all, I have not thought about my life past a year or two. So now I see it that I need to get deep within myself to figure out what exactly it is that I want.
God is about to give some people some specific instructions. And listen to me very well. It is very imperative that you heed the words that he's about to give you, that you obey the instructions that he's about to give you to the T. What he's about to do for you is going to set your life up forever, for generations and generations and generations. What God is getting ready to give you are some divine instructions. I don't need you to add anything to it or take anything from it. I need you to do everything that God is telling you to do. You will know who this is for, because some things are about to pop off in your life like never before, and your life is never going to be the same again. Get ready, get set, and go. Obey God's word to the T. He is setting you up for success. Catch and receive it.
And last night I had a series of dreams, but the only one I can remember is the most important, I feel.
I tried telling you all the story in the clips, but I just cannot say it for the life of me. Last night, I had a dream and it felt very prophetic. And I'm gonna be honest with you guys, I do not have prophetic dreams. My dreams are potential outcome type of dreams, like visions. And then I don't ever know that they're visions until they happen. In this dream, basically, I don't know where this was. It's me and three ladies sitting on this curving concrete bench with a plant, like a tree behind us, like a planted tree. There's a homeless lady, a black homeless lady, and she had a mic and an amplifier. So the thing is, this homeless lady that has a mic and is saying stuff, she looks at the first Caucasian lady on this bench and she goes, da 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 da, something with diabetes is not even doing something. And then she gets to the Caucasian lady right here next to me and then she goes, da 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 da, but apparently it was true because we were all like, wait. So what she said about you was true, but we weren't talking to each other. We were just thinking and we were making the face that was giving, wait. Okay, so how did she know these things? Like, this is true, apparently, because look at how they look and this must be true. Then she gets to me because I'm in a third position. I know, because first person point of view. She says, okay, there's the man in the gray, and skips me and goes straight to talking about the light-skinned lady and says something true about her. And I'm just like, why she skip me? I know they thinking that it's a black person thing. But that wasn't it, because my mom walks up on the scene right after she got done talking about that light-skinned lady and goes, ma'am, your son needs to be preaching in the ministry. Here's the thing, when I recorded this clip the first time to you guys to tell you guys this story, you notice what I was wearing?
OMG, I did not see my outfit at all. And she said the man in gray, but I just knew it was me. Because I was sitting in the third position. But she said the man in the gray, and I just realized I had gray on. you know, for these past couple of weeks, I want to say 2 weeks, I just have like so much faith. I'm just like wondering what's gonna happen and when. Like at this point, I'm just worrying about myself, and I don't think I'm doing enough at all. But he continues to show me that he forgives me and that I'm still on the right path.
God has been giving me instructions since 13. The whole correction was technically a series of instructions. First, it was let go of the old so God can make room for the new. 2 was cling to God for him and not what he can do for you. 3 was to preach to people about salvation, not to their comfort. And that's exactly what I've been doing.
He asked me for work this morning regarding some of you guys, and what God said was, it is only the beginning. You have no idea how great it is about to get. It feels as if you are stagnant in this time, and this stagnation is beginning to make you feel hopeless. It feels as if you have been left with nothing, but that is wrong. I had to stop everything in order to get you ready for the next season. The instructions that I have given you in this time are complete. The assignments that I gave you have been complete. So yes, I understand why you feel stagnant, my daughter. I understand why you feel stagnant, my son. I want you to know that in this time, I am preparing you for one of the biggest comebacks you have witnessed in your life. You feel the spirit of stagnation upon you, and God is saying that I have allowed it to happen, and it's in my divine plan, because in this time you have completed and you have obeyed the things that I've told you to obey. So you may have had like specific instructions that God was giving you in this time. God is saying to some of you that I have allowed this, because I want you to know that the next season hasn't opened yet, but it's about to open. But in this time, you are in this place where you've completed everything that I've told you to do, my son, my daughter, and I'm so proud of you. And I do not want you to think that I've left you. I will never leave you nor forsake you. God is saying to some of you that I'm preparing you for the biggest comeback. When the blessings start to rain down, I'm telling you guys, you're gonna be like, where did this come from? It's going to be out of the blue. God is about to take you into your next season, but everything's on hold right now, and God is doing it for a reason, so trust him.
And to see I'm about to have a comeback means a lot.
There's not a lot of people that's going to be too happy about your comeback. And let me stand corrected really quick. There's not a lot of people from your past that think they know you that's going to be happy. See, they know the old version of you, and they didn't want to take the time to get to know the new version of you, because they have this preconceived notion of who you are in their own eyes. Sad to say, they're not going to be able to see you or perceive you in this new light. But you've been walking in this new light for quite some time now. You've been having the Holy Ghost sitting with you, dwelling with you, living in you, on you, shining upon you, and you're blessing so many people. But just like Jesus, they don't recognize your anointing because they choose not to. But understand this, that doesn't take away who you are. It didn't take away who Jesus was, and it doesn't take away who you are. I need you to continue pushing forward. And yeah, it might hurt a little bit, but guess what? Your glow up is going to shut the mouths of your enemies.
You're like, okay, so what does this mean? I was wondering the same thing until a little bit of time goes by and I see this.
A table is being prepared for you in the presence of your enemies. You have no need to fear the haters. Fix them a plate to go.
The thing about that TikTok is that it was another confirmation for the Twitter tweets that I have been seeing for months now. And I have been known what to do or what to stop doing. And now I'm actually about to stop doing it. And that, my friends, is feeling the need to explain myself about my past and fear of people believing it. And the truth is, the more I talk about it, the more I believe it myself. And I know what happened.
So with that being said, there's a lot of stuff that I'm just going to deal with behind the scenes, because I feel like some things that I present in these episodes are what's being, you know, enemy thoughts that I perceive to be my own. And I feel like that's what's messing me up, especially when I present certain information into these episodes.
The tweets that I have been seeing consistently for months were like, stop looking back. Not everything deserves a reaction. God's opinion of you is the only opinion that should matter. Even when saying all of that, I continued to run my mouth until God showed me a reason why I had to stop running my mouth. The enemy was putting a twist on everything that I remembered until I eventually ended up believing in all of it. The man in the blue shirt of 13 literally said that I need to let go of the symptom that is making me believe things falsely. And the fear, like the guy at the very end of the last episode said, needs to die. Those symptoms and that fear were the last single aspect of caring what people think that I was telling you all a minute ago that I need to work on. And like the woman in 10 said, the only opinion that should matter to me is God's. And the thing is, I'm growing in Him and I'm finally getting a grip on who I am. So with that being said, this is how I'm moving from now on.
Whatever you hear about me from now on, believe it. Believe that shit. Put a spin on it, twist on it, suck on it, spit on it. Believe it, because I don't even care.
Okay. Now we're back to the 26th, and speaking of Nicki Minaj.
Now, the queen, I've never really seen her tweet about this type of stuff. And she was my confirmation, because look at what the queen Nicki Minaj just tweeted.
So I know you all are wondering, what does this mean? Remember in 13 when I told you all that I was going to Conyers, Georgia, and then eventually Athens? Well, Georgia is the hub of my enemies. So that means all the TikToks and all the tweets saying that a table is being prepared for me in the presence of my enemies is just confirmation that I'm going back. But with what that curly haired lady in 10 said about my opposition and how they're going to look at me and how it's only going to magnify God's glory and hands on my life, alongside the adorable lady with the glasses and the denim shirt on in the office said, I feel like I'm going back for my magnification. With a person that I see coming, he had to have dealt with this to become the unstoppable force that I was feeling that he was. And I genuinely feel like this is the beginning of that.
Okay, what's up everyone? So, in this vlog, I just changed my name again. I talked to my best friend about it, and we both ended up talking about my name change a few days ago. And we talked about his new name. For me, we talked about it a while ago. I'm gonna say like 3 weeks ago, and then we just brought it up 2 days ago. I was like, I kind of want to change my name to Sandeo. And then we both kind of like came to terms, and we was like, nah, I like Sunday. And I was like, you know what? Yeah, I do like Sunday. So then 2 days ago or yesterday, he called me back and he was like, you know, when you asked me about your name change, I said, you know what? I'm starting to feel Sandeo now. And then I was like, nah, bro. I think I'm good. I'm gonna leave it at Sunday. And then I got the feeling earlier today and I said, God, please send me confirmation that if I should change my name to change it. That was it. I said a simple little prayer and I let it go. And then next thing you know, I'm just watching a TikTok and it had nothing to do with music. And my name comes back to me, Sandeo, 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 Sandeo. So I'm not midday, I'm not great day, I'm not Sunday, I'm Sandeo.
So the thing is, I'm filming this sectional a month after this scene was filmed, and I love how I just realized that I got my name changed right after I literally just learned to finally give it all to God, and I could not be more thankful and happy. So now 3 days have passed and it is now July 30th. As I was on the toilet, I received an email about something that was very important to me, and it was a huge blessing about my car. So now I can get it looked at and hopefully fixed.
I did just receive another miracle. Something just worked out in my favor yet again. And thank you God, I'm still on the right path. Yes, I just received another part of the miracle, another miracle. This is two. You know, out of all the other miracles, like the ones that I specifically prayed and asked for, I got them, okay. So I wanted to show you last night, and then I'm gonna talk and get you guys updated with what I just saw.
God has a message that he is wanting me to release to some of his people, but this video has taken 5 attempts because it's about spiritual warfare, so I'm not surprised. The devil doesn't want you guys to know the things in which God is about to speak through me, so I'm just gonna get straight into it. God said this morning regarding you guys, the enemy is trying to torture my people in this time through their thoughts, their dreams, and their minds. Advise my people to stay in consistent warfare prayer even when they are not getting attacked by the devil to keep themselves covered. It may seem like specific dreams are real, specific thoughts are your reality, but they're not. The devil is trying to twist things in this time. If you have a dream of yourself committing a sin, cleanse yourself immediately when you wake up. Do not allow the enemy to accuse you. Remember, the enemy is the false accuser of brethren. So God is saying to some of you that in this time, the enemy is trying to attack your mind severely and your thoughts. And of course, the enemy sees our minds as a playground, right? And God gives us the authority through his spirit dwelling within us to rebuke the enemy, to not fear him, because really and truly, the enemy is fearing us more than we may sometimes have fear.
What you all just saw was a TikTok confirming everything that I had said prior to this. And those clips that you guys saw future me deleting was me explaining myself, inserting those August 5th clips back into July 26th. And to be honest, I'm over it. I need to make room for God, and like I said in 11, alongside with what that man in the blue shirt in 13 said, I need to remove these old ways of thinking and these old habits and allow God to come in and make room for the new. And this is that.
And I'ma just say this. I feel like, I don't know what it is, but something is like soon. Child, like, I'm feeling something in my spirit again. Like, I feel like, you know, amongst that change that is coming, I feel like it's upon me. Like, he keeps prompting me to get up and to go ahead and, while I'm chilling right now, play my music that I'm listening to while scrolling through social media, play that music on my speaker and get to getting ready to get things down, because something is sooner than I think. It feels abrupt in a sense, but I'm not sure.
Another day has passed and my mom ends up telling me that there's something that she needs to talk about, and I could not be more proud.
I will be talking to my 2 partners down there on the East Coast.
Yeah.
See where I'm going to be staying when I get there.
Right.
I've been offered my dream job.
Really?
Yes, I've been offered my dream job. It's a huge multi-million-dollar deal that she's she's working on. And she's growing a team, and she wants me to join her team. She wants me to be a core member, core VIP member. She said, Trina, you got your passport?
No way.
Yeah.
You were just telling me this in 11 or 12.
If I would have went ahead in June and applied for that passport, I'd have had it by now.
Oh, you didn't ever put on your little makeup on, and I'm gonna go get my passport. Well, now we know that it's a must to go and do that.
Mm-hmm. I don't want to get it now because we're leaving. It has nowhere to go.
Oh yeah, so you have to get one over in Georgia or Tennessee, wherever you end up.
Where I end up.
The last time my mom and I were discussing something on camera, we were not perceiving what God was doing for us. So with everything that had been revealed to me, corrections and all, I have been showing it to my mom to help us hopefully get into an alignment with God and on one accord.
It is the end of the beginning. A new pathway is being paved for you, my son, my daughter. A new name is being given to you, for your status is changing. No one is going to see you coming, but this path I'm about to lead you on is going to lead to success. From being last to being first. From being unappreciated to being appreciated. From being hidden to being unhidden. No more laughing, no more laughing. Your enemies had their laugh, and now they will stare at you in shock. They will find it unbelievable that I could have blessed you in such ways. So God is saying to some of you that in this time, he has been confirming to you that you are about to be led on a new path, right? And in general, you've been feeling like a shift and a transition in your spirit, like you've been seeing things in the natural moving and shifting in your life gradually. And God is saying to some of you that it's because I'm about to lead you on a new path. You are beginning a new.
Okay, so to make a long story short, we got blessed very much through the car. Unfortunately, I do not have a car now. And just in the correction, I'm making all things new and they don't even perceive it. That thought just came to me just now. So unfortunately, I do not have a car now. And we only have one car now to get back. So I just wanted to give you guys an update on everything. We're gonna be leaving next week. But here's the thing. I'm holding on, you know, I still have faith. My car is a total loss, so that fell through about getting my car fixed, and apparently my auntie's not in her place. My auntie, she's staying at a friend's house. Her house is still very much like a war zone right now. That's like, it's a mess. And we told her that we were gonna be there next week, and she said, oh dang, like, I'm not even there yet. I'm not even there because it's, you know, it's too much there, it's too much going on. And it's like, I'm staying at a friend's house. So now we don't have a place to stay, and we only have one car back. And I was really expecting this to just be a smooth, easy transition. I was hoping to end this chapter off on such a high note. And I'm not gonna say it's not gonna end up on a high note, because something, anything could happen in these next few days. Anything could happen. I was a little sad because I didn't know what to make of all of this. A few hours have passed and it is now the very next day. Excuse my face, I have stuff on it, I have product on it. Y'all remember when I told you guys when I find happiness, it's over for you BITCHESs. When I woke up after, you know, talking to you guys last night and, you know, seeing all of those videos and 13 back up in my face, like, you're ready, you got this, you know, I prayed to him, you know, with that stuff on my mind, I prayed to him this morning. A pure heart and a pure intention, I tried to, at least, you know. First, I didn't want to pray to him so early because I was like, I was just getting up. I don't want to go to him with, like, you know, half-baked prayer because, like, I'm so fried from sleeping and I'm just waking up. I was like, let me just do it. And you know what? It made a difference in me just praying to him, because I had prayed to him to, like, you know, change my heart, my soul, and my, you know, like, to make sure that I really align with him and not what he can do for me. And, you know, I read a word today. I listened to some music, and I have more to do today. But what I did differently this day was ask God for clear instruction, like I've been told to do. It's to cling to him. So that's what I'm trying to do. And I'm trying to get clear insight from him each and every day, like she told me to do in the correction. So I did that. And I went to go take a shower, and I had the thought, you know, like after prayer, I was feeling really good. You know, I was like, you know, I'm getting all jazzied up off this, you know, the prayer's like really helping me. Like, I'm getting all jazzed up off the prayer and everything. So I'm like already moving 10 times better than what I normally do when I wake up. The thought pops into my head, you see what joy you have when you focus on the right things, when your intentions are pure, and when you're truly seeking out Jesus. Because when you're truly seeking out Jesus, you have no option but to be joyous, but to be happy. And then instantly, right after that, the state of joy popped up right back in my head.
I never lost my faith in God, but I was just a little bit sad because I couldn't process what was going on. But seeing how God gave me joy despite all of that made me really happy, because I was genuinely trying to do right by him. Because despite everything falling through, I still chose God.
The way the Holy Spirit has been downloading within me is incredible. So I'm checking my email today and I see that you're coming out of your Gethsemane. It was the Garden of Gethsemane when Jesus had went and prayed 3 times and said, God, you know, if you can allow this cup to pass from me, you know, do it. But nevertheless, let your will be done. And see, I know these past 6 months have been hell for some of us. God was only testing us like he did his faithful servant Job. He allowed the enemy to strip things from us, to take stuff from us, to see, will we still choose him when we didn't get the house, when we didn't get the car, when we didn't get the job, when we didn't get that marriage, when we didn't get our way, will you still choose me? Even when my way means that you suffer, God, glory. Even when my way means that you gonna hurt a little while, will you still choose me? And that email meant so much to me because it said you coming out, because you chose God. No matter what go on, no matter what I don't have in this life, the material things don't mean nothing to me. I still choose to serve. And just like Job, everything is being restored to you. You in a season where you gonna get everything back 7 times fold, 100 times fold. Baby, you are in this. Baby, a lot of y'all feeling like, God, I don't know where I'm at. I don't know where I'm standing. I don't know if you still here with me. God said, baby, you just where I need you at, because you endured. See, I didn't need you to do much. I just wanted to test you and see, would you stay with me?
I know you guys are like, okay, so literally, didn't he like do all this in chapter 2? Like, he already said he was getting back to me and everything. So the thing about that is, y'all, as y'all had to see, I had to learn some lessons to realize why things are happening in the way they were. I was meant to learn everything through God and not
you know, using things of this world to get me out of something, because clearly that didn't last, right? And two, I can't help but feel that I'm like right on time with something. And not even in the sense of like, God can bless me now, is that a third? But no, it's not about that. It's like I feel like my mindset shift was like right on time. Cause like based off what I told you guys, I felt like something keeps telling me like the time, I'm like right on time.
I'm so thankful to God about what I'm feeling in my spirit about another change. Because the last few times I prepared for change, I got it.
You know, when the test came in right after the lesson that I thought was a test, y'all remember when I got sick, right?
I knew that sickness stopped me from doing the things I was supposed to do, but I did not realize the real effects of me not doing what I was supposed to do. I'm aware that that sickness stopped me from doing the things that I was doing, but now I'm really starting to understand the full effects of me not doing my positive morning routine. Anytime I will get one thing accomplished from my morning routine, it will feed my soul good energy. So by the time I will go outside into the beautiful open world and look to the sky, write in my Project 369 book, play music that made me look to the future with hope, alongside with a little side prayer, I would already be high on life. Then I will summon all my angels around me to go and work on my behalf and bring me back things that were meant for my life.
In the beginning, I really was killing it. I was really talking to God. I was really listening to good music. When that sickness took me out and all my habits stopped forming, I didn't understand how that in itself was an underlying issue that came about.
I say that to say that is that I am now a lot stronger in God. And I am actively asking Him to continue to mold my heart, soul, and mind to align with Him. And I am genuinely trying to put God first.
And so I don't know if I'm tripping, if I just heard, you know, my mind was just doing something, but I just want to document this. I think I'm going to claim it. I just heard, and just like that, when I was editing. And it sounded like it was kind of over my own thoughts. You know, like it sounded like it was like an interruption. I'm not sure. I want to hold on to this. I want to claim this energy. But I heard, and just like that.